edition of the Influencer Talks. Employability has been an issue in India for a very long time. Even though there are a lot of engineers, IT professionals, and others, they pass out of Indian premier institutes every year. But in spite of all this, we always find employment and employability as an issue. Economy is growing very fast, markets are growing, but still employability is an issue. Today, I have invited one of the finest educationists in India, Professor Colonel Shishir Kumar, Director General, Imagine XP. He has been into industry in the educationist for the last 42 years. He has given 29 years of distinguished services in the Indian Army. He's also a Kargil War veteran. So let's welcome Professor Kumar. Professor Kumar, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Atulji, for inviting me for this show. I'm feeling grateful and obliged to you.
Thank you, sir. And to start our conversation, I would request you to tell us something about your distinguished services in the Army and your experience in the Kargil War.
Yes, sir. What happened that I have spent almost 30 years in Corps of Electronics and Mechanical Engineer. Right. During Kargil War, I was the commanding officer in one of the largest battalion of Indian Army that is located in Northern Sector. Our troops has also participated in Kargil War.
Okay.
Kargil War, you all know that how it has started and how we could be able to conquer and throw them back from our border.
Right.
My regiment has participated and started giving engineering support right from the day the war has broken and up to the end. So during those operations, we call it OBVIJAY.
Right.
Our battalion was also adjudged one of the best battalion of that sector.
Wow, that's brilliant, sir.
We lost one of the JCOs also during the war who was working in Taras sector, sir.
Okay.
And Indian troops are very brave, courageous.
Absolutely.
They did extremely well and result is in front of the people of India.
We all salute our armies, armed staff and so on. So my first question, you know that we are talking about the employability in India. See, we all have seen, I have observed it. We have hundreds of thousands of engineers passing out, IT professionals which who are passing out. But, and also there are vacancies which are available, but somehow we find a kind of skill gap, which we have been talking, but it's still widening. So what's your opinion on that, sir?
So there are many reasons for that.
Yeah.
The very first reason is we are not able to build the mindset for employment in our students.
Okay.
Students are only worried about their marks. Even the parents are also focusing on the marking,
right,
whether you should get 80%, 90% or good marks.
Right.
But let me tell you that marks is not at all essential for getting employment. Your interpersonal skills takes importance.
Right.
Your etiquette, mannerism, behavior, and your problem solving ability, which is lacking. Application is lacking. Mm-hmm. We keep feeding the students with only concepts.
Right.
Their practical knowledge and how to use those concepts in life situation,
right,
is totally lacking. Too much focus on theoretical input is there. And lastly, which, right, is the most important reason, industry requires Apple and,
right,
university and academia is giving them Orange. Our content curricula is totally outdated. Suppose the student who has taken admission in engineering this year, he will be passing out after 4 years.
Right.
After 4 years, you should be a visionary enough to appreciate and apprehend that what will be the requirement of the day. Absolutely. And accordingly, we should give them the inputs.
Right.
So we are not updating. We are following the totally archival syllabi and contents.
Right.
Whereas the requirement is technology is moving in such a fast pace that whatever is being taught today, it becomes irrelevant tomorrow. So there should be a mechanism to keep updating these technological inputs to the students.
Absolutely.
And let the students should be sensitive to the growing needs of the technology and other areas which are taking place. So these are some of the plausible reasons our people are not getting employment as they should have got.
Right. But sir, what do you suggest? How do the Indian education system overcome this issue? That's very important.
This is a very nice suggestion, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And let me tell you, I have authored a book and the title of book is, Sorry, You Are Not Employable. Build a mindset for employment. First of all, our students have to be totally innovative and creative.
Right, right.
They should be thinking.
Mm-hmm.
And in any syllabus, we don't teach them how to think. That is the worst thing.
Absolutely.
We have started now imparting training to the students across 18 universities who had partnered with us,
right,
a compulsory subject known as design thinking. Design thinking is a subject which gives you the technique and tools for solving complex problem. We call it wicked problem.
We define
wicked problem as the problems which if you solve it by using your gut feeling,
right,
then you will give rise to 20 other problems. And that is what is happening in our country,
right,
that we use our judgment and gut feeling to solve a problem, and it gives numerous other problems which we are unable to solve.
Absolutely.
So design thinking is very important. And nowadays it has been made compulsory in most of the Western universities.
All right.
And therefore, because it gives solution of the problem, gives rise to innovation. And you have to keep innovating every day. The method, process, procedure, everything requires innovation.
Right.
So the solution of these problem is manifold. Focus should be shifted to the future skills. First point.
Yeah.
Second point is you should be giving emphasis to practical rather than theoretical input. That is known as learning while doing.
All right.
I have read a quote to quote Churchill, Winston Churchill.
Yeah.
I hate to be taught, but love to learn.
Absolutely.
Unquote. So the point is, all the teachings of our teachers, renowned teachers who have got ample number of degrees from institutions like IIT,
right,
is not getting transformed into learning, sir.
Absolutely.
So it can only be transformed into learning when they will be learning by doing a project and applying whatever they have learned side by side. So this is also given lot of importance in every institutions.
Right.
I'm very happy that now UGC has come with suggestion, project-based learning.
All right.
And the project-based learning means you have been given some concept, you make a project, use those concepts, and then your paper will be complete. So the point is our focus should be shifting from marks to the evaluation of the student based on their learning comprehension.
Right.
And some work has started in this direction.
Right.
And our new education policy is focusing on all these problems.
All
I'm
right.
happy to see. And let us hope that desired change will be taking place in the examination system and other systems also.
You rightly said, sir, that its mindset has to change. But what we are talking here is about the university level or higher education. But I think the mindset has to come from the basics, from the grassroots, from the school level. So how do you suggest we actually take it? Because see, even in schools, there are a lot of activities, whether it is science or it is cultural or whatever. So that mindset has to be developed right from the beginning.
So you are absolutely right.
Yeah. All of a sudden, after doing the higher secondary, you cannot switch in, back to some kind of creativity or. Yeah. So how do you suggest that should be taken care of?
Sir, basically, the CBSE board has already taken these points into consideration.
Right.
And therefore, they have started from 6 to 8 design thinking. This subject has been started, included in the content and curricula of CBSE.
Right.
Class 6 student will be given the basic idea of design thinking.
Right.
There is another paper of 30-40 periods in class 7.
Yeah.
And class 8, they will be doing real problem solving. So the focus is on that. In 11th and 12th, they have introduced 2 more paper. One is design. The name of the paper carrying 150 marks is design. Another is web design, because they have understood that in any business, until unless you communicate to the entire world, and the best method of communicating to the world is what you intend doing through the website.
Absolutely.
So they have also introduced website.
Right.
And next thing is the mindset has to be changed from the parent side also.
All right.
Parents are still in the mode that Pandeji's son has joined IIT, therefore my son should also join IIT.
Absolutely.
Without realizing the potential, caliber, and the passion of the child, you will start sending him for JEE, advanced JEE, main, and all those competitive examination.
Right.
You are just blunting the area.
Yeah.
We must understand, and parent must understand, that every child who has taken birth, they have taken birth to succeed in their life.
All right.
They all have got enormous strength.
Absolutely.
Let us encourage them.
All right.
A parent's responsibility is to create ecosystem, right type of ecosystem for all round development of the child, and give them encouragement. That is the job of the parent, and let child decide about his future.
Right.
Only thing I wish that if Sachin Tendulkar would not have joined cricket, and if he would have joined medical science like his better half, I don't know what would have been the future of the medical science and the future of the cricket of India.
Of course. You rightly said that we have skill gap, and the best way of resolving this issue is that the curriculum are designed as per the requirement of the industry.
Very
so here, industry also plays an important role. So how does industry and the education, they come together? So what should be done, or what is being done?
Sir, I had been on the both side of the table.
All right.
Once I was in academia as a director of a university, I attended a meeting in Fiki.
Okay.
I told them there is a provision of giving professional training to the engineers.
All
but wherever engineers are going for the professional training of 6 months, in that organization, too much focus is on meeting your schedule, meeting your production output. So nobody has got any time to teach those students or train those students. Therefore, this was in my back of mind. Yeah. And when we started our own company, Imagine XP, the theme was,
yeah,
if academia cannot reach out to the industry, why can't industry reach out to the academia? So we did like this. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you, we had a industrial conclave organized in Pune.
All right.
We invited topmost people of the industry, and we started a conclave of 2 days. In that, we found out that what are the technological requirements of the industries.
Right.
We jotted down those areas. Mm-hmm. Then we made some advisory committee in those disciplines.
Okay.
And they suggested that what should be taught during, suppose, artificial intelligence, user experience design,
right,
product management.
Gee.
So we have got advisory body. They recommended everything. After 2 days, we invited academia, the expert in the universities, and we told them that this is the industry recommendation. What do you say now?
Right.
Every proceeding has been recorded.
Yeah.
And then we came out with a complete curricula in each and every field.
Right.
And after doing that, we approached university that let us partner together. And you will be very glad to know that today we have partnered with 18 universities where we are teaching future skills. And 80% of the teachers are from industry, but 20% teachers are also masters, PhD, and they are from academia.
Right.
So nowadays, and in most of the subjects, whatever we are teaching, it is not evaluated in a conventional way.
Okay.
We have got a jury, and each and every subject is being followed by a project. They make something, and the jury comprising of one industry member, one academia, and another teacher who is teaching the subjects. They will be assessing the student and evaluating the student. It has got additional benefit. Their communication skill, their confidence, their self-belief increases, which makes them employment. And in this way, you will be very glad to know that at present, we have got a virtual university platform on which we have got more than 1,500 students studying with us. They are studying in the university. They will be getting the degree from the university.
Right.
But we have got 65 teachers on our roll, and they are teaching that.
Wonderful.
And we have started also teaching many future skills through online platform.
Okay.
We call it My Coach platform. Okay. We have developed it just last year. And we give the, we started giving also some of the degrees, some of the certification in the right area. And you will be glad to know that the most of the people who have done these courses are getting employed gainfully, and they are very satisfied and very happy.
But I think that this needs to be taken on a much wider level so that no entire country is covered with that, so that we get the
right. Taking this cue from you, let me also tell you that UGC has recently taken a decision under this new education policy that they will authorize some of the renowned university. The number is quite high, maybe 200 plus, whose NIRF ranking is very good and whose NAC ranking is also A and above.
Right.
They will be authorized to do entire degree with the help of the platform, where the practical needs can be met by the virtual online platform.
Okay.
So they are permitting it.
Right.
So like Western University, Princeton, Harvard, MIT. Now you see that India also will start giving online degree to the students. And this will be very helpful for those who could not complete their education because of the resource crunch, because of the responsibility they got of the family.
Right.
And they were not adequately educated.
Kattal Kumar, we have one more issue here. One is skill gap, which we have discussed, and it can be though slowly because it's a huge economy.
It takes time. Change takes time.
But at the same time, we have another issue, major issue in the industry, and which is upscaling. People have got jobs. They have been there for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 6 years. But by then, the technology or systems or the procedures, they completely change. So how do we take care of upscaling of the people who are already into jobs? Otherwise, in very near future, they will be jobless because the things will change.
Yes.
The technology will change.
I totally agree, Atulji, with you.
Yeah.
I remember what Mahatma Gandhi has said about it.
Uh-huh.
To quote, live as if you are going to die today.
Right.
Learn as if you are going to live forever. Unquote.
Absolutely.
So, the concept of lifelong learning is very important.
Absolutely.
And therefore, you see that there are Japanese companies, they are right from CEO to the last man of the company.
Yeah.
They had to go compulsorily 60 hours of training cycle every year.
Absolutely.
If you do not update yourself, if you do not upgrade yourself, then you are going to become redundant because technology is moving in very fast pace, as I have already narrated it beforehand.
Right.
So we have to keep learning. Absolutely. And this can only take place if you devote certain time out of your job, out of your on-job training and other things on updating yourself. Absolutely. This is very much required. You see, I have started this Imagine XP at the age of almost 65. Somebody says that 65, at the age of 65, you have got a startup baby. So we have to learn everything. I'm basically a graduate from NIT, postgraduate from IIT, MBA from Delhi University. But I have learned design. I have learned what is design thinking. So you have to keep learning. There is no end to learning. And everybody must make it a point that every day we should be at least devoting 2 hours on our self-improvement. It is our responsibility, sir.
Gee, absolutely, absolutely.
And at the same time, it is in responsibility of the employer also to make sure that they should create a good environment and ecosystem so that, and reward, proper reward system should be there to encourage and inspire the employee who are updating themselves in their own time.
Very true.
And this is happening. This has started happening, though the pace is not as it should have been.
Right.
But I think that the correct focus, directional changes are taking place now.
All right. That's good to know, sir. Now, let's talk about the current global situation, which is an outcome of COVID-19, coronavirus. There is a new normal in education now. Schools are now closed for almost months. Not hopeful that they will resume very soon. Same with the colleges and other institutions. And what we think that it is now, change has been now for longer to stay. Or the things will never revert back to the normal what was earlier. So it is a new normal now. So how do you think this has impacted the growth of a student at a school level or college level or institution, how will it impact negatively as well as positively? So, and what should be done to overcome these issues?
Excellent question, sir. It is not only going to adversely affect the student, but it is a challenge for the teacher also.
Absolutely.
Because while giving online training to the student, they have to make sure how to make their lesson plan very interesting so that a student should be listening to you. They should be live in the present. Otherwise, what will happen that in the first 5 minutes of an online class, a student decides whether they should remain in the class or they should start daydreaming.
Absolutely.
And therefore, your first 5-10 minutes of the class should be very interesting. And how to make your lesson so interesting that your student should be listening to you. Right. Teacher must plan all these things.
Right.
They should also plan that how to, first of all, I will explain about the teacher, then I will tell you the effect of the on the students.
Okay.
So teacher must plan their lesson very, very aptly, very nicely. There should be role playing.
Right.
There should be some storytelling.
Yeah.
Straightway, they should not be coming on to the topic of the teaching. They should connect well with the previous lesson.
Absolutely.
How important it is to learn this lesson. All these things are required to be done by the teacher. So they will have to put for 1 hour class. Yeah. It is said in the academia that they have to prepare in a offline mode 4 hours initially.
Exactly.
But in this case, they may have to prepare 5 hours. Then only they will be an effective teacher.
Very true.
Second thing is, students also gets bored. There is too much strain on their eyes looking at the computer screen.
Yep.
So there is a need of limited hours of the class. And luckily, people have realized it. And in place of 6 hours training scheduled, now they are having 3 hours and 4 hours.
Right.
There should be adequate break between the classes.
Absolutely.
That is also required. Mm-hmm. And students should be encouraged to do exercises, yoga, meditation. There should be classes for that also.
Right. Right.
So these are the ways and means. And this is going to stay. All that I'm going to tell you, UGC is also understanding the requirement of the new normal.
Yeah.
And therefore, the content of every course, they are planning to have 20, 30, 40% of those contents as online courses.
Right.
And keeping these things in view, we have developed our platform, as I have already narrated earlier. In that, what we do that, we are having varieties of skill courses for first year student, second year student, third year student, fourth year student, even they can appear in the competitive examination like CAT, MAT, GMAT, GRE.
Right.
So we take care of entire student life cycle in the university.
Right.
In first year, they are slightly new, and therefore what they can learn is soft skill. We have introduced 2-3 papers of the soft skill, presentation skill, team building skill, all those things can be there.
Yeah.
They can learn programming language in the first year, C, C++, Java.
Yeah.
In second year is technology oriented. Whatever technology they wanted to become expert. Today, what is happening? The basic problem is there is very less practical exposure to the students.
All right. Yeah.
So these courses, online courses, will give them extra fillip and they will provide them extra practices. Assignments are there.
Right.
Continuous counseling is there. Mentoring by the experts will be there.
Right.
There will be career counseling that if you are doing mechanical engineer, in what area you should develop, what right. you should study.
Right.
Should you study the CAD/CAM or should you study mechatronics? All these things will be taught. If you are a student of computer science, yeah. you should learn data science, AI, machine learning. What should you learn? Right. Or cybersecurity? They will be continuously counseled, monitored, and accordingly in these areas, they will be developed.
Colonel Singh, what I want here is now, as a senior educationist, I want you to give three lines of wisdom to the main ingredients who actually play a very important role. Number one are the parents. Number two, your fellow teachers. And number three, the students, so that they could come up with the challenges. Brief one-liners, three each to each of them.
For parents,
yeah,
recognize the capability of your world right. and provide right encouragement and inspiration to him.
Right.
For teachers,
yeah,
empathize with your students. All students have got strengths and weaknesses.
Right.
Let us make sure that they develop in the area of their strength.
All right.
Then you told for students. For students, it is very important to understand.
Yeah.
They should not compare themselves with anybody.
All right.
They are unique and unparalleled. Let them develop self-confidence yes. and self-belief. They should start thinking, if I can't do this, who can do this?
Absolutely.
This approach is very important.
Yes. I think,
In addition, I also tell my students, take vitamins every day. I had been a good coach.
All right.
My vitamins are different.
Mm-hmm.
Vitamin A is for action.
Okay.
Complete your work, today's work today, so that it will not be giving you any stress.
Yeah.
Vitamin B is belief. Have belief in yourself and your own capability.
Right.
Vitamin C is confidence. It comes with the preparation. Prepare so well that you will be confident about your success.
Right.
Vitamin D is discipline. I always tell them,
okay.
There you have to go through two pains. One is going through discipline, pain of going through discipline. Mm-hmm. And another is pain of repenting at the end. Mm-hmm. But the problem is the another pain is weighing in tons, whereas first pain is only weighing in ounce. And vitamin E, I always tell them to take is, whatever you do, give your fullest energy level. E for energy, E for enthusiasm, and E for empathy. And last vitamin is not doctor's vitamin. So far it was all vitamins prescribed by doctors.
Mm-hmm.
Last vitamin is vitamin I. It is implementation. We know many things, but we are not able to implement in our life.
Yeah.
And the way we start implementing these value system,
right.
you will be at the top of the world and nobody will be able to touch you. And if you are going to conclude it, I always say our students, "Ae parinde, yun jami par baith kar kyon aasman dekhta hai? Pankhon ko khol. क्योंकि जमाना सिर्फ उड़ान देखता है
क्या बात
लहरों की तो फितरत ही है शोर मचाने की लहरों की तो फितरत ही है शोर मचाने की लेकिन मंजिल उसी की होती है जो नजरों से तूफान देखता है. रिकॉग्नाइज टूडेज टाइम एंड प्रिपेयर योर सेल्फ, टेक इट एज ए चैलेंज, यू विल बी द विनर. माई बेस्ट विशेस टू ऑल माई स्टूडेंट्स, योर ऑडियंस, एंड थैंक यू टू अतुल जी योर सेल्फ दैट यू हैव गिवन मी अपॉर्चुनिटी to interact with the students, parents, teachers, and many audiences who will be listening to you.
Thank you, sir. Pleasure is all mine. And I really thank you for your time, Professor Shishir Kumar. And thank you very much. Your talks will go a long way for the students, teacher, and the parents all across. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm grateful, obliged.